Hello guys, my name is Bumi Asala. Our YouTube channel is Bumsy's Lifestyle. So thank you for watching, thank you for subscribing to our community, and if you've not subscribed, please subscribe, it's free. Our channel is always lively. We talk about the skins, we talk about food recipe, we talk about lifestyle, we talk about good things. So we appreciate you and welcome you to our community. Remember to subscribe. And today's topic, we'll be talking about the virtuous woman. Who is a virtuous woman? Are you a virtuous woman? So I will be with my Bible. This is my Bible. We'll be talking about the virtuous woman and would try to iron it out. I believe every ladies, we want to be a good wife, we want to be a good mother, and we want to also groom our children, lead our children, our daughters to be virtuous women. So as we start, Holy Spirit, take control. All our viewers, minister to them and touch their heart as we go into your world. We'll be reading Proverbs 31. Proverbs 31 verses 10 to 30. The woman who fears the Lord, that's what my Bible says. An excellent wife who can find, she is far more precious than jewel. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and work with willing hands. She is like the ships of the merchant. She brings her food from afar. She rises while it is yet night and provides food for her household and portion for her maidens. She considers a field and buys it. With the fruit of her hands, she plants a vineyard. She dresses herself with strength and make her arms strong. She perceives that her merchandise is profitable. Her lamp does not go out at night. She puts her hand to the staff and her hand hold to sprinkles. She opens her hand to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of snow for her household, for all her household are clothed in sackcloth. She makes bed covering for herself. Her clothing is fine lining and purple. Her husband is known in the gate where when he sits among the elders of the land. She makes linen garments and sells them. She delivers sashes to the merchants. Strength and dignity are her clothing, and she laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teachings of her kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he also praises her. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hand, and let our work praise and indicate. Praise the Lord. I'm not a perfect woman. Let me just say that. I'm not a perfect woman. I just feel like doing this topic on my channel. So I believe it will bless you. Thank you. So now, who is a virtuous woman? What is a virtuous woman? According to the Hebrew term, it's called Eliet Chali. Eliet Chali. And what does it mean? It means the virtuous woman, a woman of valor. And the word Eliet is the word woman. Then Charlotte is defined as valiant, strong, and virtuous. You know, this term Eliot and Charlie, or the virtuous woman, is only found in the Bible 3 times. Do you know that? It's found in the Bible 3 times. We see her reference in the book of Ruth and twice in the book of Proverbs. The first in the book of Ruth, we see a brave widow sacrifice her own well-being and prosperity to take care of her mother-in-law. How do you take care of your mother-in-law? How close are you to your mother-in-law? Me, I'm very close to my mother-in-law. I can remember some times ago, years back, when I traveled to the UK, I met with a friend, a distant friend. We're not that close, but a friend. And she was telling, then I was a single lady then, and she was telling us that when she gets married, that she prays mother-in-law dies. And I was shocked to hear that. Are you that type of lady? Please don't be a Jezebel. Don't be a Jezebel. Be a virtuous woman. Connote the quality. Proverbs 31 verse 10 to 30 says, don't be a Jezebel. If you want to be happy, and if you want God to be happy with you, be a virtuous woman. So I continue. As she goes out on a limb to provide for her family, her kindness, generosity, and faith in the face of adversity are valued. And she is called Woman of Excellence. Because of our time, I'm not going to read that. You can read it on your own. Ruth chapter 3 verse 11. Then in the book of Proverbs, we find 2 more accounts of the Hebrew words. It's referenced in Proverbs chapter 12 verse 4. And the virtuous woman is described in full in Proverbs 31 verses 10 to the end. Please read it and meditate on it. So now, who is a virtuous woman? What are the qualities of a virtuous woman? The qualities of a virtuous woman is, number one, a virtuous woman is trustworthy. She doesn't lie. She doesn't backbite. She's not a double person. She's a straightforward person, and she's very truthful. Anything you hear from her mouth, she's very truthful. She's also encouraging. She encourages people around her. She doesn't discriminate. She loves everyone that surrounds her. She works diligently. She's very hardworking. Are you hardworking? Are you that lady that depends on your husband on every little penny? Are you diligent in your home? How do you take care of your home? As I said, I'm not perfect. I'm also learning as this has ministered to me also. So I'm also learning. She's strong. She's always well prepared. She's generous. She's brave. She's resourceful. She's full of wisdom and well thought of. She prays for her husband. Let's read Luke chapter 10. Hey, come on. Luke chapter 10, verse 38 to 42. And most importantly, she fears the Lord. Then the concluding part is, how can you be a virtuous woman? How can you be a virtuous woman? She must obey God's word. You must be God-fearing. You must love God. You must do everything God wants. You must have a Christ-like attitude. You must have a Christ-like attitude. You must be prayerful, a prayerful woman. You must love. You must pray for your husband, your children, your family as a whole. You must be very prayerful. And she must be a glue to the gospel in the sense that you must also know your Bible. She must know the word. She must meditate on it day and night. I hope with this short message that I gave you now, I hope it's useful, and I hope you learned from it, and I hope you gained something from it. To you, are you a virtuous woman? What does the definition of a virtuous man, what does it mean to you? Can you put a comment below?